everybody, Ann here, and today, see that thing up there? I think I'm gonna set it on fire. But I'm also going to create another little planting container. Make that a big container. I pulled this out of the tiny house. I was using it as my nightstand, but I got those three cool tables, so I'm using the big table by the bed, the medium-sized table by my chair, and so this one I am going to, well, just make a planter out of it. And this time, instead of doing the holes on the bottom, I'm going to do like other people suggested and do them on the side. I used to do that in Ohio, but then some of my plants started getting signs of like root rot or whatever that is, was getting too moist in there. So I'm going to go ahead and try it. I am going to go ahead and put the sticks and the leaves down in the bottom and then try and decide what I'm actually going to plant in it. I think I'm going to put it here, and I'm not going to put it up on top of anything because I've got my little holes and it's going to be able to drain out that way. Patricia suggested that I put in rocks, and I've got a few extra rocks that I took out from underneath of these things. But I may put them underneath of these, I may not. But even so, I've got other things I need to do with the rocks. In fact, I need to collect a whole bunch of them, and I'm going to put them underneath this gutter area, you know, until I can get actual gutters put in so that the rain doesn't come down and destroy this whole foundation. So I don't think, you know what, I'm just going to go ahead and put the sticks and the leaves in there and just hope that that works, because I don't think I can spare any rocks. I don't have enough of them around here. Alrighty, so let me go fill this up and then decide what to plant in it. Well, look at my little buddy. Y'all know what that is, don't you? That comes from that big web thing. And I saw them crawling up on my porch the other day, and I thought they were so cute. But you know what? I am totally going to kill this. Sticks are in. I got my leaves in, and now it is time for the organic humus and soil that I've been using. So hopefully I've got enough to fill this nice big bin up, and then I gotta decide what I'm gonna plant in it. I got my soil in, and soil and humus, and it's about 50-50 of each. And I just layered it in, and then I would go in and toss it with my hands. And I still have just a little bit soil left. Maybe I could add that to one of the other planters or plant something else, who knows. But now I think I just need to water it. Let's grab some water that I got out of my rain barrel. We're just gonna give it a nice soaking. What's Betty barking at? Hey girlfriend, what you barking at? What's going on, girlie? Ooh, she's got her hackles up. There must be a squirrel. Yeah, let's just soak this a little bit more. Oops, I need to not move this camera around so much. Get it nice and wet, even though it's raining tonight, since I'm going to be planting something in it today. And you know what I think I'm going to do? I think I'm just going to plant two tomato plants in here, because this is a big enough container. And maybe some basil. Isn't basil complimentary? Yeah, I'm going to have to look that up. So yeah, definitely two tomatoes and then something else. I got my two little tomato plants in there. Actually, there's a whole bunch. I'll only let one grow. I'll thin the rest out, whichever ones are best. We'll get to live long and prosper. Let's just... I think that's enough for now. I already soaked the holes. Whoops! That wasn't a smooth move. I went ahead and watered everything. I mean, why not? In case it doesn't rain tonight. It is supposed to rain tomorrow, and so I didn't want them to go a whole day without getting watered, but I wanted to show you something that I think is pretty cool. Remember this little spot here in between these two trees that there was like a pile of just mulched old branches and whatnot? One of my commenters suggested I plant some dill in it, the mammoth dill, and I haven't been really looking at it for a few days. But let me see if I can get this in focus for you. See there? See there? That to me looks like dill. There's been some other things that have been coming up, like this. That's not dill. And we've got something, some more coming up over here. See? I'm going to see if I can get a still photo of it so you can get an idea, a better idea. Now there's something else coming up here. I don't think that's still. Over here, I don't think that's still. So let me see if I can get a picture, just a still photo, so you can tell me if you think that's what it is. I'm pretty sure it is. See that there, right in the middle? It's very delicate looking. It doesn't look like any of the other stuff that's going around it. I really, 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 well, I really hope it's still. I'm pretty sure it is, though. What do you guys think? Here's another shot of it, and there's some kind of on the left, a little bit more off to the right, and I don't know. I just think that this is till. Please, 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 Heavenly Father, let this be till. Well, whether it is or it isn't, I'm going to go ahead and just water it a little bit today, just in this area, just to hopefully, please let it be till. Please let it be mammoth till. I would love to have just a huge patch of mammoth dill growing right in this area and just let it grow and grow and grow and grow. So let's keep our fingers crossed. I think I've decided on sweet basil to plant along with tomatoes. They're supposed to be good to plant together with them, improve the flavor and repel bugs. So you know what? I'm just going to use up the rest of these seeds and plant me some basil right next to my tomatoes. I think I'm going to just do 4 little spots right out here, right in front, and drop the seeds in and hope they grow. You're not gonna be able to really see what I'm doing because the little seeds are just totally black, but I'm not dropping them in there very deep. I think they only need like 1/8 of an inch, but I'm putting several seeds in each one, so who knows if they will sprout or not. I hope so. I'm just going to cover them up a little bit, very gently. And then I think I'm just going to water them just a little bit. Let's just do this very, I may not be, that's okay. It'll be all right. Very gently. There we go. I think that's good. Does this look nefarious? It should. In fact, I'm a little bit scared because I need to find a way to cut that limb down without getting any snakes by me. All right, well, we're just gonna see if I can do this. I wanna just saw it down and then set it on fire. I've almost got it, but something like flew in my face and I don't know what it was, so I just need to get back out there and do it just a little bit more. Whew, almost done. Now all I gotta do is pull it down, and I know at least one of those little caterpillars tried to escape, but let's just get this out and take it somewhere. Whoa! Take it somewhere and set it on fire. This is going to be the first time I've ever actually used my fire pit, so I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to separate the longer pieces off of it and just kind of put that nest down in the bottom and then put the other sticks on top of it, set it on fire, and kill these gross little things, these webworms or whatever you call them, tent worms. Kill them with fire. Look it. They're all trying to escape. They're all trying to escape. I should have done this over the fire pit. Oh my goodness. I know this may be disturbing, but I have to. I'm killing them. I'm going to kill them all. Let's set this baby on fire. Come on. Oh, they're trying to escape. They know what's going on. You are going to die. Sorry. There we go. Bye-bye. I think that was successful. Maybe I ought to throw a few more logs on the fire. Why do I love fire so much? I don't know. But I killed all those little wormy things in that web. So my fire pit works great. By the time you see this video, it's going to be Easter Sunday. So I wish you all a very, very happy Easter Sunday. I hope you spend it doing something that you really, really love. I know I will. And, well, you know what, guys? That's all I got for you. See you in the next video. Thanks for watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed the video. Make sure you like, subscribe, hit the bell, and y'all have a good one.